More news tonight. Terry Blair is now a convicted serial killer.
The victims' families are overwhelmed, but the judge who made the ruling took a swipe at investigators in the case. Peggy Bright is live with continuing coverage. Peggy?
Well, Lara, Judge John O'Malley heard the case without a jury and delivered his decision today with a half an hour's worth of explanation. But what mattered most to the victim's family were the judge's final words.
I find beyond a reasonable doubt that the defendant, Terry Blair, is guilty of murder in the first degree for the murders of Sheliah McKinzie, Patricia Wilson, Anna Ewing, Darci Williams, Claudette Juniel, and Carmen Hunt.
The tears were flowing, the hugs among families, an expression of relief. Terry Blair remained emotionless, just what relatives would expect. The mother of victim Darci Williams.
Very careful, and I appreciate his honesty, and I appreciate the fact that he could discern between what was right and what was wrong.
But not all of these relatives were so confident, like the niece of victim Carmen Hunt.
I was like nervous at first. I mean, because it was like, at first it seemed like he was going to get off, you know what I'm saying, because really of the evidence. But after it was over with, I'm just relieved.
Judge O'Malley explained in great detail why he found Blair guilty. He also criticized the police on the case for sloppy and unfactual reports because of a network camera crew that followed them throughout the investigation. But the relatives defend the detectives and the work they did. Listen to Patricia Wilson Butler's daughter.
They made mistakes. They're human. They made mistakes. They never had something like this on their hands before. They made mistakes, but they did their job.
Now, the A&E film crews that followed police have not been back since 2006. We are live at the Jackson County Courthouse. Back to you, Laura.
Peggy, thank you. Blair will not be facing the death penalty. Prosecutors agreed not to seek it in return for Blair's agreement to have a trial by judge instead of a jury.